Hello everyone. Welcome back to my channel, Bow and Arrow Tarot. Today we're going to be doing the weeklies. Alright, it is the weekly for September 15th to the 21st. And we're going to get right into it with Leo. You guys showed me so much love. I'm putting you guys out first. We're going to go around the zodiac chart, starting with you first. Alright, Leos. So let's get out your three messages for the week, as we always do. It is safe for you to love. Let your friends help you. And we have let go of control issues. Bring these down a little. All right. So, three different messages. You know, in the weeklies, I take a look at a few different spreads. Possibilities. We're going to pull out your three animal spirits that you may or may not be resonating with this week, and that's fine too. The weekly forecasts are for general, so it could be in love, life, or career. Let's see what's coming out for you, Leo, this week, September 15th to the 21st. We're already halfway through the month. It's going by quickly. Gazelle energy, beauty in motion, right? Fire energy, of course. Then we have fox energy, right? Earth energy. This is a very stable mate. Someone who is really providing a lot of support. This is very good energy for a love connection, for sure. And then we have starfish energy, which is, of course, water element. Interesting. Three very different animal spirits, fire, earth, and water. With gazelle, we talk about having heightened senses. Right, the gazelle is really beautiful. It's beauty in motion, right? But the gazelle has this very heightened sense of awareness and can be a little bit over concerned, right? Over worried. So gazelle energy comes in at a time in our lives where things may have been a little bit hectic, right? And you know, it's time for you maybe to sit back, try to relax. You're missing out on the beauty of yourself and those around you because you're worrying a bit too much. And then again, a lot of this has to do with just a heightened sense of vulnerability. All right. The gazelle is the animal card for vulnerability. All right. And so when you're feeling vulnerable and you're heightened to that kind of energy, you can begin to sort of see everything as a threat as opposed to seeing the beauty in things. And so this is more of a warning card to relax, right, and to enjoy the beauty around you. Now, the fox is interesting as well because this is earth energy. And with the fox, we have one of these beautiful animal spirits that is like the perfect mate. The fox is extremely intelligent, wise. This is the card of the teacher. You ever notice in the fairy tales or in the comics for little kids, you know, whenever there's like an animals depicted, the fox is always teaching the class of animals, teaching the other badgers. So this is a very sort of intelligent animal spirit. And again, this is an animal spirit that's very grounded also and extremely supportive and comes in with a lot of solutions. This is the type of animal spirit that helps you when you're in, we're talking about the type of person who's like going to be a good mate to you when you're in a difficult situation, when you're going maybe through some trials and tribulations. That person who's really rock solid, that person who helps you come up with solutions, who doesn't just let you kind of flop in the wind, that's that fox energy. Strong, supportive earth energy. Can certainly be a friend as well, a very good grounded friend. Now we have starfish energy, which of course is water element. And starfish, with the starfish, we talk about being too concerned with surface and pretty and the outside and how you look and appear to people. So with starfish energy, the admonishment here is take care not to rely so much on your good looks to get through life, because you do yourself a disservice. The starfish does indeed have much more beautiful qualities deep down inside, and to only rely on the exterior is kind of denying yourself your true purpose in life. This can be a friend, or it could be a stage in your life where you're feeling, again, maybe a little bit vulnerable, and you may be relying on sections of your life that are more to do with your status and your looks and these type of more easily attainable things. Only because you fear perhaps going a little bit deeper, perhaps you feel being inadequate on a deeper level. And so the starfish energy kind of comes in also to encourage you in a sense that, yes, even though you're beautiful on the outside, you can be beautiful on the inside too. They're not mutually exclusive. All right. So let's get into your 5 or 6 spreads. Maybe 6 to 8. We'll see, depending on how deep each spread is. For our lovely Leos, for September 15th to the 21st, in love, life, and career, general reading. Let's see. And again, these may or may not resonate with you, and that's all good too. All right, let's get right into it. Death, Hanged Man, and we have Knight of Cups. So some of you are certainly dealing with a lot of transformation, right? This transformation may have recently just started. Could be a change of job, or you may be moving, changing career or location. It's really a death, but it's interesting. The death is kind of in the just past present period. So it may be a period of change that you've been going through, yet you're still kind of feeling a little bit stuck in some way. Hanged Man comes in to let us know that you've decided or you've seen something that's made you kind of feel like you want to work a little bit more. You want to come out of this very comfortable, some call it stuck energy. This is, you know, it's also more like, you know, just being satisfied with less, not having to work as much for things. And so you kind of remain in this sort of period of stasis. Sometimes it can be a period of stagnation. And so although this transformation is coming into your life, there is another portion of your life where you still kind of seem to have remained kind of stuck. But yet now, most recently, something else is coming in to make you want to move in that direction. And I think it may be indeed a love interest. Somebody is coming in with this Knight of Cups, and they kind of are interested in you. They want to make a connection with you. But in this area, interestingly enough, you still kind of are unwilling to move. It could be that because you have a lot of change happening in other areas of your life, that with regard to your love life right now, or the possibility of taking on a new relationship, you really are still kind of feeling like you're not ready to dive into that just yet. Death brings with it a lot of change in general, and so I think it's probably wise to, for the time being, maybe indeed remain where you're at until you see where the chips fall after this change. Because you're just not sure if this Knight of Cups, and there's too much turmoil right now in your life to make room right now for a new relationship. Six of Wands, Justice, and Three of Cups. So some of you have certainly going to be having a victory this week, in a sense that it's a little victory. It's a bit of a vindication. This could be at work, or this could even be in your social group. It could be that you've been holding on to a particular stance, right? Or a particular position that was perhaps unpopular. Perhaps people were feeling like you weren't really going to win with that position. But then something happens this week. Some information comes in. I want to say that it could be be a legal situation or an argument that you were having with someone that's being dealt with in an official capacity with this justice card coming in. In any case, the scales get balanced in the way in your life, and certainly this victory comes in. And as a result, you have a celebration, Three of Cups, with like-minded individuals. For some of you, this could very well be some social activism that you were perhaps a part of, maybe a social action that you were trying to accomplish, right? Because with Three of Cups, we talk about a celebration of like-minded individuals. Sometimes this can certainly include a social group or a political group, an activist group, a humanitarian group. And so with this victory and justice coming in, some of you who are certainly in that area or that field, right, are going to be getting your vindication this week. And it's really, really, really good news for some of you. Sun, Ace of Pentacles, and the Magician. So some clarity comes in on the work front or the career front for some of you this week. It's as if certain opportunities, perhaps that you've been waiting for, are finally starting to come in. And certainly there's a main opportunity coming in for you that is in the area of your career or your abundance, in a sense, or your business. For those of you maybe who have your own businesses, there's something really new and exciting that comes in this week. And I'm going to say this is a really good offer that comes in, because it comes in under the air of clarity with that sun. When the sun is in, it kind of sheds light on everything really around you, and it really lays a lot, strips everything down to the bare essence. So there isn't, you know, it's not so much a case of wondering if this opportunity is really favorable or is what it seems to be. It is indeed what it seems to be. There's no hidden agenda or ulterior motive. You can be confident that if you take this opportunity with the right attitude, it will certainly be favorable for you. Magician energy is coming in as well. It may feel for some of you a little easy, right? You may be a little bit apprehensive because this opportunity coming in, although it promises to certainly increase your abundance and maybe even your status or your standing within your career, it does come to you very easily, okay? And so don't be put off by that. We all have magician moments, and it could just very well be that this is your moment to shine. Just because the work comes easily to you, it doesn't really negate that clearly you have a talent for this. Now, those of you who are resonating with this, you're going to know what I'm talking about, because this is very much going to speak, this opportunity is very much going to speak to a particular skill that you're very good at and that you accomplish with ease. This is not going to be something difficult or something that you have to now learn a whole new field for. This opportunity is well within your house. And in this way, for those of you who are resonating with this, you're going to know exactly what I'm talking about when it comes in. Moon, Nine of Swords, and Ten of Swords. Wow. So some of you certainly start off the week with a lot of Piscean energy, in a sense that the moon is, you know, it's emotions that may not be extremely clear right now. You're not sure if what you're feeling may be true or if what you think the other person you're dealing with is feeling may be accurate, and you're having a lot of sleepless nights about it. There's a lot of anxiety involved. It could be that you're very well resonating with gazelle energy, in the sense that you're feeling very vulnerable. This is certainly in the area of a relationship somewhere or a friendship, but one where it is very personal. It is certainly a relationship perhaps of control, or maybe letting go of control issues. It's quite interesting because you have Nine of Swords leading right into Ten of Swords. So it's almost as if this week you begin kind of with this confusion about the feelings, perhaps the mixed messages coming in, and you have a lot of anxiety, but there is a breakthrough that happens this week, where you finally realize enough is kind of enough. It's the end of, you're ready to put this period of anxiety and turmoil behind you. It could be that some of these emotions that you're feeling or some of this confusion with this particular individual that you're dealing with, there's some clarity that comes through, right? Some understanding. Perhaps some of your friends, especially with friends helping you, it could be that a friend of yours sheds light on a particular scenario that you were really having a lot of anxiety over, but now that once your feelings are kind of clear, or once it becomes clear why you're feeling the way you're feeling, sort of your intuition is kind of affirmed, you very firmly are willing to put all of this behind you and you're done with the anxiety. It's almost as if, I don't want to say that anybody's in like a cheating scenario, but it's like there's definitely information that comes to light that allows you to finally free yourself from a relationship that's really had you in its grip. Emperor, Empress, oh, and the World, wow. Some of you absolutely come together with a perfect love connection. This is definitely Emperor, Empress. What else can I say? And the World. So, Leo, for some of you, this week you realize, it could be that you're realizing it this week, but you may already be in this relationship with this person. I want to say that if this is not a new relationship just starting, it may have started maybe in the last 6 months. So it is fairly new, but this week is the week where you both kind of realize that you are simply made for each other and this is it. You know how you have those moments in a new relationship? I don't know, it doesn't always happen and it may not have happened for everyone, but you know, one of those relationships where it starts off great, it's wonderful, you know you love this person, and then after a very short period of time, not only do you know you love this person, but you really, really realize that you two are made for each other. Emperor and Empress, this is the divine feminine, divine masculine, right? So, you know, what else can I say? And the World card comes in to reaffirm that this is in fact a perfect connection, because the World card is letting you know that you're both exactly where you should be in your lives and with each other. So this is very fated and very destined. For some of you, if there has been issues to do with control or anything like that, all of that goes out the window. Some of you may even agree to move in together or to get married. Page of Wands, Ten of Wands, Three of Pentacles. Some of you are starting a new project, right? This new project is almost coming out of a reinvigoration of your creative side, Leo. It's almost like you're reborn with this project or this new idea that you want to pursue. You feel like your youthful excitement coming back, especially for those of you who haven't been doing anything creatively, maybe for some time because you've been working. This new endeavor is extremely exciting and it gives you a lot of confidence. Because you're finally able also to lay down the burdens of the past. You're able to say, as a result of this new opportunity coming in, you're able to finally put the stage of really difficult stage of carrying a lot of responsibilities, a lot of self-doubt and low self-esteem issues around with you, right? You're really able to put that behind you because something has come in to sort of reinvigorate you and reaffirm that you are a creative being, that you deserve to be doing creative things. This can happen after a period of maybe living a life where you were doing a lot of working, taking care of the kids, and now the kids are older and grown, and you're realizing that you are now, have this renewed sense of creativity and freedom coming in. This could be after a period of working very hard to get a particular degree, and you've had to make a lot of sacrifices, but now comes a period where you can actually work in your field and you're finding it very exciting. This is the kind of dynamic that I'm talking about, and it ultimately leads to an increase in your work and your career, to a step up in your career, to perhaps some recognition of your skills and your work. For some of you, this is definitely going to be, you've graduated perhaps college or schooling or education in a field. For some of you, it's certainly going to be saying goodbye to the responsibilities of perhaps having to deal with a family or raise children. And this new stage that this week becomes very much apparent is extremely creative, and it's in a field in an area that is very close to your heart, Leo. This is going to be the last spread. King of Pentacles, the Fool, and Six of Swords. So some of you are certainly on a path to a new stage in your life. The Fool is at the center. The Fool is always the quarant. It's always you guys, whoever we're reading for. And so when the Fool shows up, it lets you know that you're about to take, maybe go left or right or take a skip in life, but there's a certain path you're about to go on. That is a diversion from where you are now, that is different from where you're at now, and it requires you to pay a lot of attention right now. Okay, there is a King of Pentacles in your life who is willing to support you. Perhaps this is a family member or a friend who's willing to help you on this new path, and help you sort of make this transition a little bit easier. Part of this new journey is going to be moving towards a more harmonious way of interacting and communicating. This could certainly be a change in your career. Okay, again, and it could be a change in your living conditions. Some of you may be moving out of an environment that has been very hostile, very controlling. And in order to get away from that environment, this King of Pentacles is coming in and offering their support. Very much a let friends help you and let go of control issues scenario. And they help you out of a very dicey situation, perhaps a very constricted situation, into another situation or another environment that is much more conducive to harmony, that is much more in line with peace and where you wish to be mentally. It could be that up until now, you weren't ready for this change, but you're certainly ready for it now. And you certainly have either one friend or a couple of friends who are able to help you financially with this change. All right, guys, this is your weekly forecast for Leo, September 15th to the 21st. If this resonated with you, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, and share. But for right now, I'm just going to say have a wonderful week, Leo, and I'll see you next week for the weekly. Bye-bye now.